Hello, my dear students. Hope you're fine at home. Today we will take up chapter number 3 from Exploring English book. The name of the chapter is Annual Haircut Day. So this is page number 31. The name of the chapter is Annual Haircut Day. Read this story about a man who has a haircut only once a year, which means annually. Once a year means annually. So the story is about Sringeri Srinivas. This is the person and he cuts his hair once a year. So let's read page number 31. It was the annual haircut day for Sringeri Srinivas. Sringeri Srinivas left home as usual to go to the local barber. But the barber said, "Today I have no time to cut such long hair." Feeling sad, Sringeri Srinivas went back home to ask his wife for help. But his wife said, "Today I have no time to cut such long hair." Feeling a little angry, Sringeri Srinivas went to his friend, the tailor. But the tailor said, "Today I have no time to cut such long hair." Now a little worried, Sringeri Srinivas went to one more friend, the carpenter. But the carpenter said, "Today I have no time to cut such long hair." So there used to be a man named Sringeri Srinivas. He had long hair, as you can see in the picture. He used to cut his hair only once in a year. That means annually. So that was the annual haircut day. That means he had to cut his hair that day. So he went to the barber. So who is a barber, children? Barber is a person who cuts hair, isn't it? But the barber was very busy. So he said, "I don't have time to cut your hair. You have such long hair." He felt sad about it. So he went back home. After that, he asked his wife to cut his hair. But his wife also refused. She was very busy. So she said, "I have no time to cut your long hair." Next, Sringeri went to take help from his friend, the tailor. But the tailor was also very busy. And he said, "I don't have time to cut your hair today." This made Sringeri very, very sad. And next, he went to his other friend, the carpenter. He was also very busy. So he also said the same thing. He refused. He said, "I have no time to cut such long hair." Now we come to the next page. This is page number 32. Let's read page number 32. Poor Sringeri Srinivas. It seemed no one would cut his hair on annual haircut day. In tears, he walked off by himself past the village forest. He sat near a cave and cried loudly. "The day is nearly over. How can I keep my promise to cut my hair? Oh God, help me." The tiger, sleeping peacefully inside the cave, was very disturbed by all the noise. He came out roaring, waving his giant paws at Sringeri Srinivas. Poor Sringeri Srinivas was so scared that all the hair fell off his head. Sringeri Srinivas ran all the way back to the village. The tiger went back to sleep. Now Sringeri Srinivas would not need a haircut for a very long time. So poor Sringeri Srinivas, he was very sad, he was worried, he was anxious. He thought that no one would help him and he started crying. He went out of the village and after that he reached a forest. He sat near a cave and started crying loudly. There was a tiger inside the cave and it was sleeping. The tiger heard Sringeri's cries and woke up. The tiger was very angry and he came out of the cave. He saw Sringeri. Now Sringeri Srinivas was so scared after seeing the tiger that all his hair fell down. So after that, Sringeri ran all the way back to the village. So he returned to the village and the tiger, he went back to sleep. Now, Sringeri was happy now. Why? Because he had no hair on his head and he would not have to cut his hair for a very long time. Now, here we have the summary of the story of Sringeri Srinivas. Sringeri Srinivas cuts his hair only once in a year. So, on annual haircut day, when Sringeri Srinivas wants to cut his hair, he goes to the barber, his wife, the tailor and the carpenter. But no one helps him. Poor Sringeri Srinivas goes past the village forest. He sits near a cave and cries loudly. This disturbs a tiger sleeping inside the cave and it roars. Out of fear, Sringeri Srinivas's hair falls off. Now he is happy. So this is all about the chapter, Annual Haircut Day. So you'll read the chapter twice. Now let's write a few hard words in our English classwork copy. Write the name of the chapter, Annual Haircut Day, Lesson 3. Give the heading hard words and you have to write it two times. The first word is annual, A-N-N-U-A-L, annual. Local, L-O-C-A-L, local. Barber, B-A-R-B-E-R. Varret, W-O-R-R-I-E-D. Carpenter, C-A-R-P-E-N-T-E-R. Tailor, T-A-I-L-O-R. Village, V-I-L-L-A-G-E. The next, peacefully, P-E-A-C-E-F-U-L-L-Y. And the last word is disturbed, D-I-S-T-U-R-B-E-D. Disturbed. So write the hard words neatly in your English classwork copy. That's all for today. Thank you.